based on reports from Reuters and Interfax. A Malaysian Airlines flight with about 295 people on board has crashed, we are told.
Тобто вже можна говорити, що він не сам по собі через якісь ушкодження або ж поламки впав на територію Донбасу, а саме був збитий?
Безусловно, цей самоліт був збит. Вчора були введені санкції проти Російської Федерації очередні. Це відповідь його на ті санкції, які були введені.
Obviously, the world is watching reports of a downed passenger jet near the Russia-Ukraine border. And it looks like it may be a terrible tragedy.
Is that an area that a commercial airline should be flying over at all?
You know, I wish that they had thought of that ahead of time.
Хочу звернути вашу увагу, що ми цю називаємо не інцидент, не катастрофу, а терористичну.
All evidence shows was perpetrated by the so-called separatists. We call them terrorists. And this crime shows why we do that.
The Supreme Allied Commander in Europe, General Philip Breedlove, he's looking at NATO AWACS airplanes. Those are radar airplanes.
And again, the question now, and we've heard our Nick Pitton-Walsh reporting concerns from Ukrainian officials about their ability to actually get to the crash site. This is obviously essential that officials get to the crash site, not only to get the black box, to recover any other items.
В домі бив, слышу гул, взриви, два було взрива. Вискочив, смотрю, дим чорний, думаю, племянника моєго накрило. Вибіжало, оно тут таке чорне, все горить, все.
How important and what sort of a time frame is it crucial that investigators get access to that site in?
Well, it's critical that they get there as soon as possible for a couple of reasons. One is for the investigation, but most importantly for the humanitarian side, for the recovery of victims.
Well, you can imagine that that the Ukrainian air traffic controllers have probably already pulled the tapes, and that they will then transcribe, or it will be given up to Eurocontrol to transcribe that air traffic control conversation.
По-дальшому ми оприлюднюємо розмови, де вони обговорюють, терористи, що прибули на місце падіння літака.
Да, майор.
Значить, це Чернухинський збили самоліт. Його там через Чернухинського блокпоста. Казаки, що на Чернухина стоять.
I'm Patrick Lancaster, and I'm here 60 kilometers from Donetsk in Ukraine. And this is the site of the Malaysian Airlines crash that happened some hours ago.
If it was a missile that took this plane down, then it has to be a very sophisticated weapon system. And the Ukrainians do not have that capability.
When you say the Ukrainians themselves don't have that system, are you talking about the Ukrainian government in Kiev, or are you talking about Ukrainian separatists?
The Ukrainian government in Kiev.
В Україні вперше відновили зенітно-ракетний комплекс «Бук-М1», до якого входить одразу кілька одиниць техніки. Раніше його ремонтували лише в Росії. Там же розробляли і виготовляли запчастини. Ця техніка не працювала 2 роки. Не вистачало фахівців і коштів. Враховуючи ситуацію в країні, Міноборони знайшло і гроші, і спеціалістів.
Ремонт проведений якісно. Комплекс поставлений в військову частину. Зараз проводиться приймання здавального випробування. Після їх завершення комплекс буде готовий виконувати завдання за призначенням.
Даний знітно-ракетний комплекс застосовується для знітно-ракетного прикриття від ударів з повітря атомних електростанцій, адміністративно-політичних центрів, міст, групувань військ.
Let's talk about the Ukrainian military. They, as we've seen over the past few months, are not in good shape. Were they, let's say that they did have these weapons, which obviously they do.
But again, we don't want to jump to conclusions until we have absolute facts of the case.
Продолжение темы оружия. Интерфакс, ссылаясь на слова компетентного источника и данные объективного контроля, сообщает, что вчера в район Донецка был перебазирован дивизион противовоздушных комплексов БУК Вооруженных сил Украины.
Но, тем не менее, как в Москве, так и здесь, в Киеве, конечно же, все вспоминают ту же историю 13-летней давности, когда в украинском небе, в небе над Украиной был сбит российский самолет, погибли люди, и было точно известно, что в том районе вели учения украинские военные, но, тем не менее, официальный Киев опровергал тщательно эту версию.
Anybody, any party in this conflict has the ability to do this. The Ukrainians shot down mistakenly an airliner, a Siberian Airlines airliner, in 2001 over the Black Sea.
Well, the questions I'd be asking is, number one, who could have shot it down? And the Ukrainian government has been quick to blame it on terrorists, which is, you know, their name for the Russian insurgents. And there does seem to be some growing awareness that it probably had to be Russian insurgents. Now, how we determine that will require some forensics.
Они сами говорят о российской возможной агрессии, о том, что они привели свое ПВО и ВВС полную боевую готовность. И после этого, вот в месте, где они провели свои ПВО и ВВС полную боевую готовность, они открывают коридор воздушный для гражданских самолетов. Ну, на мой взгляд, это, мягко выражаясь, неразумно. А так, в принципе, очень хорошо пахнет спланированной, заранее спланированной провокацией. Любой технический специалист скажет, что ПЗРК или зенитная установка до такой высоты не бьет, никак не может ничего сбить. Другого оружия у нас нет.
Vice President Biden has been on the phone with Poroshenko four times in the last couple of weeks.
We're in touch with the Ukrainian government. As I said, I was on the phone for the better part of a half an hour with President Poroshenko.
За моїм дорученням Генеральний штаб планує зараз передислокацію військ. Ми змінюємо тактику.
The Ukrainian president also confirmed that his government will negotiate with rebels in the east of the country in order to establish a humanitarian corridor to the crash site.
Сьогодні війна вийшла за територію України.
Right now the sun's coming up and the emergency crew has restarted its actions here. I'm not sure if they're waiting on inspectors to come before they start removing the bodies and the debris.
These are emergency service personnel who've been on the scene for a couple of hours this morning. As you can see, they're holding sticks with white cloth on the top of it. They're marking bodies.
The fields are burnt and in them there are bodies and body parts, and they're strewn over a large area of land around here. There's fighting taking place, what, about 10 kilometers away from here. We can hear the booming taking place. So it's a difficult crime scene, and it's going to be very difficult for the investigators to get in here and do their work.
We assess Malaysian Airlines Flight 17 was likely downed by a surface-to-air missile, an SA-11. Operated from a separatist held location in eastern Ukraine.
Прекрасно, пусть предоставляют документы, будем смотреть, какой это пуст, чей это пуст.
When you, Marie, and other officials were talking about missiles along with tanks going from Russia into Ukraine to supply the separatists. Did those missiles include SA-11?
I don't think we have specified to that level of detail, Matt.
Нет, самолет не был сбит ополченцами, и это достаточно очевидно. Ополчение не располагает средствами ПВО, которые позволили бы сбить этот самолет.
You don't have any information to share with us with about whether you even know for sure that SA-11s were in?
I don't have any specific information about a book system making that transit. We're not ruling anything in or out at this point.
Today, tragedy proves again that the terrorism is not local, but global issue. Russia's aggression against Ukraine is not only our problem, but a threat for European and global security.
The Ukrainians do have SA-11 systems in their inventory. However, we are not aware of any Ukrainian SAM systems in the area of the shootdown.
We need to point out that the Russian authorities have, and the Defense Ministry particularly, has said this morning that it picked up radar transmissions from a Ukrainian missile site at the time that this tragedy happened.
Я вам напомню основной принцип римского права, который действует и сейчас. Кому выгодно это? Выгоден этот сбитый самолет?
This is the crime against humanity.
all red lines have been already crossed. This is the deadline.
Когда я думаю об этой ситуации, мне вспоминаются слова господина Порошенко о том, что готовит для ополчения сюрприз.
What really jumped out at me and disgusts me, if I may, is today you saw already looters at the scene.
I actually didn't see any looters at the scene myself, to be completely honest.
Well, we're going to go back tonight's this evening and write up what we saw and what we heard.
There has to be order reestablished very, very quickly. Those bodies are decomposing, as I said. There's a lot of firepower, and I should add also that we also heard what sounded like missile fire in the background.
Basically, this is the territory which is not under our control, but we do hope that soon everything will be under the control of Ukrainian authorities with the assistance of Ukrainian army.
The Ukrainian government claims that rebels basically carried out some kind of a drive-by shooting in the area, but the video, the images we see, do not look like small arms fire killed these civilians. It looks like it was, again, some kind of artillery, and this taking place today.
Нікуди, за що нам таке угоди? За що?
Скорая, 40 минут.
Це Порошенку глотку, йому треба запхати його сюди.
This is all going on as there are calls right now for a demilitarized zone around the crash site for international investigators to be able to go in. It is a very, very chaotic situation where people and civilians continue to die even in the hours after this plane went down.
Они, тем не менее, приехали, вот люди видят, стоят люди в панике, они успокаивают, рассказывают, так и так, все хорошо будет, сейчас вас соберут, эвакуируют. Они, блин, стараются нам помочь, спасти.
Сегодня в полчетвертого утра приблизительно нефтеперерабатывающий завод был обстрелян системами ГРАД Украинской национальной гвардии.
Никакого вреда не представляет, в нем находится шрапнель, он когда разрывается, вылетает больше сотни шариков, которые разлетаются.
The least the president can do is to make a damn decision for once in his life, announce that we are now going to supply lethal weapons to assist the Ukrainians in defending themselves and in completing the offensive that is now going on in eastern Ukraine to actually destroy the rebel insurgents.
Well, Charles, a moment ago you said a minute ago that the Ukrainian army has performed well. And guess who's back in the Ukrainian army? It's our CIA, it's our government, it's the Europeans and that the president has mobilized.
Необходимо беспристрастное открытое расследование случившегося. Не следует оказывать давление на такое расследование, пытаясь предрешать его итоги громкими заявлениями и необоснованными инсинуациями.
We intercepted a number of phone calls and we intercepted a number of messages in the internet.
The engagement of a range of countries and organizations, I think, in our view, makes it an international process, but of course Ukraine would have the lead in the investigation.
And the final say in the outcome of the investigation is in terms of ascriptions of culpability and so forth.
We've been hearing these reports about gunfire and explosions near the crash site. You were there earlier, and I understand you heard mortar fire yourself?
Yeah, Christy, we did. It was mortar fire, some form of artillery fire, indirect fire, something like that. It was in the near distance, certainly very audible from where we were directly at the crash site itself. And just another reminder that this accident, this terrible tragedy, has taken place within a war zone, within an ongoing conflict area, and it is yet another complication in trying to get the people and the resources that are so desperately needed to that area to recover bodies and find out precisely what happened.
Моя, да, моя.
Бомба прилетела туда, да?
Ну да. Бедная школа.
школа просто.
Это очень серьезно.
Так давайте!
Падла, Порошенко, снимаешь ты, падла, чтоб ты сдох!
Уйма, самый настоящий! Не парень! Не
парень! Уже сутки! Сюда, двое, детей, сколько?
Сюда надо, Порошенко!
Сразу это три залпа было одинаково.
Да, они вот один, второй и третий.
Минометный был огонь, он свистнул был этот свист.
А потом, когда уже встали после третьего, видим здесь дым. А после дым как прошел, раз видим люди, ну видно, что лежат люди. Сюда побежали с рынка, мужики наши пошли сюда, смотрели.
Artillery has reportedly been used in the rebel-held city of Lugansk. The Ukrainian government claims that at least five Ukrainian soldiers were killed there in the last 5 days, more than 20 wounded, and on Friday, at least 16 Ukrainian civilians were killed in that city. Of course, a reminder that this plane went down in what is an active, hot, and dangerous war zone. Mm-hmm.
Упала мина, складское помещение. Горел магазин, склады.
Пострадавшие есть?
Пострадавших нет. Потому как это было ночью, здесь все разошлись по домам. Приехали утром, ребята все затушили, да, уехали. Ну и потом где-то какой-то был опять начало сгорания.
Delegation from Malaysia arrived in Kiev this morning, from where they're attempting to negotiate access to the site. They'll be joined by eight British air accident investigators later today.
Any action that prevents us from learning the truth about what happened to MH17 cannot be tolerated. Failure to stop such interference would be a betrayal of the lives that we lost. Malaysia calls for all parties to protect the integrity of the crash site and to allow the investigation to proceed.
This area is certainly more controlled than it was, so you wouldn't say it's exactly closed off for a proper investigation. The separatists are keeping people back while the recovery operation gets underway for bodies. Now, this is being carried out by the emergency services from Ukraine. They've got a huge amount of work to do. The hope is, of course, that there will be a ceasefire here so that they can get proper international investigators inside.
Мы хотим, чтобы они как можно скорее оказались бы на месте происшествия. Однако нам было заявлено, что эти группы, да, это группа из 81 человека, она будет сегодня в Киеве совещаться о чем-то. И только завтра, возможно, возможно, завтра прибудет к месту событий.
If they not allow us to go to the site, I think this is inhumane. For we are looking at on the humanitarian ground. That's why we are calling the United Nations to assist the ceasefire. And also to ensure, we are asking the Ukraine authority to ensure us the safe corridor to the site. And this is must be done immediately.
Четыре эксперта с украинской стороны уже прибыли. Они были вчера на месте происшествия, будут и сегодня. Они сейчас в пути туда, на место происшествия, вместе с 14 представителями ОБСЕ.
Well, we're right now, this is our second day here. We were here yesterday for about 75 minutes. Today, we're getting more access. We're seeing parts of the debris field that we have not seen before. Right now, as I speak to you, we're looking at a very, very badly damaged piece of earth. The new development today was that they are what they described as experts, so-called experts here. They brought body bags with them, and they're moving. They're moving the bodies at least to the side of the road.
We have then this morning come back here. You have been waiting for us. You have seen us coming. We have now had the possibility to see a bit more of this rather large scene.
Ukraine authority workers came in, and local miners came in with their helmets and outfits being very identifiable. And they then started rounding up the bodies in their trucks here, and they're loading the body bags on the trucks, and they're transporting them out. It's a difficult thing to watch, but it's really important that it's happening. And even though it's being done crudely and they're not being put in, refrigerated or any type of vehicles that are meant for this, they are being taken out of the ground. They are being put onto the trucks, and they are being taken away. I don't know where. We're trying to find out.
Colonel Franksona, I'd like to start with you. There's been a stream of evidence coming from Ukrainian intelligence. They've been sharing some of it with me here. You have these intercepted phone calls as the plane was shot down, apparently as this missile system was delivered. You have the video that Poppy was talking about, seeming to show the missile system being sent back over the border into Russia after the plane was shot down. And there are new photographs, which we're going to share with our viewers shortly, that the Ukrainians have put out, showing not one but three Buk missile systems going back over the border into Russia. You're a military intelligence officer. When you look at this stuff, granted we're in the middle of an information war here between these two sides, but when you look at this, do you consider this credible?
Well, I have to tell you, in doing this for a long time, this seems very convenient to me that all of this information comes out just when you need it. And it's all the damning information that you would need. It just bolsters their case. Now, I'm not saying it's suspect, and the Pentagon has even said they have no reason to doubt it, but I just still, the timing of the whole thing bothers me. It's just too easy. I mean, having done this for a long time, it's never this good.